what human life is, when life was in the other forms of life that you see on the planet, nature determined a certain compulsive, instinctive ways of functioning. Once you become human, these lines have been removed. You can act consciously. That means what you call as human potential is not of any kind of measurable limit. It can go as far as you desire or as far as you have the courage to walk. So when we say human potential, unleashing human potential, it is not about reaching the peak, it is a trajectory. Because what our life is a combination of a certain amount of time and energy. Time is rolling away for all of us at the same pace. If you sit, it rolls away, if you sleep, it rolls away, if you do something, it goes away, if you don't do anything, it goes away. You're happy or miserable, it goes away. Time is running out for all of us. So it's only the energy that you can do different things with. If you bring your energies to a certain level of intensity and possibility, what somebody does in 10 years, you may do it in 1 year. This means if you live here for 100 years, it feels like in people's impact that you've created, it feels like you lived here for 1,000 years. Simply because you have managed your life energies in a certain way. So for me, a human being being impactful means, how conscious have you become? This is very important. Because if you're in compulsive cycles, then your energy gets wasted in so many things. 50% of the time is gone in maintenance. Remaining 50%, what they have, if you look at every single move that they may make with their body, their thought process, their emotions, you will see a whole lot of it is happening in compulsive cycles. If you are little sensitive to life, you will realize you are the biggest issue in your life. But I would say for 90% of the human beings, their own body, the compulsions of the body, the compulsions of their thought, the compulsions of their emotions are ruling them most of the time. So when you yourself are a problem, well, you're on self-help. We need to come to a certain level of maturity within ourselves. The most fundamental thing is, our children need not look like us, need not think like us, need not act like us, need not be us in any way. A child is not a legacy, it's a life. Influence is not important. What is important is the intrinsic intelligence finding its full potential. Not knowing is not a notion, it's a fact. It's not a notion. You really do not know a damn thing about this existence. Everybody assume and believe because it's comfortable to simply believe something. The very word belief means this, that I have concretized assumptions of which I know nothing about. Either you know or you do not know. Where does the belief come from? When you pretend what you do not know as I know, that's belief. But you can't believe something all by yourself. So you need 100 people around you. That's why always believers are in groups, seekers are alone. It is the nature of human intelligence. It naturally seeks. But people want to seek with the comfort of belief. They want to be in the belief system and then seek. Fundamentally, if people understand that the source of human experience is within you, joy or misery, agony or ecstasy, pleasure or pain, everything comes from within you. If I understand the source of my joy and misery are within me, then you know what's the obvious choice. What happens in the world, there are many, many forces involved. What happens within me, it's 100% me. 100%, isn't it? If you don't take charge of this, then you're an accidental life. When you're an accidental life, anxiety is very natural. This is why consciousness means this, that you have taken charge of the instruments of life, which on most fundamental level is our physiological and psychological space. You've taken charge of this. Now your health, your happiness, your joy, your ecstasy, your misery, everything is in your hands. You exercise them as you want. See, people have divided the universe. This is important, this is not important. This person is important for me, this person is not important for me. This is important for me, that's not important for me. Only when your attention and involvement is indiscriminate does the universe open up to you. Right now, if you make yourself miserable, you must understand you are sending a message to every cell in the body that I don't want to live. You might not have articulated it in your head yet, but when you become miserable, you notice suddenly your body seems heavy and it's like, doesn't want to get up from this chair. When you're happy, you're willing to bounce at everything and do everything, bend backwards if necessary. Why this is happening is the message has gone to every cell in the body, this guy wants to die. So you want to die, you want to live, you want to die, you want to live. The body is getting confused because you must understand this is a very intelligent body. It's taking instructions from you. Every cell in the body has enormous sense of memory and intelligence. Because you're sending contradictory messages, you're not dead, you're half dead. You can give it any number of exotic names. Essentially, you have turned your intelligence against yourself. We can talk, if inspiration is what you need, encouragement was what you need, I'm willing to talk. But talks will not bring solutions. They will bring some clarity. Solution will come only when you take a proper inward step. Because I'm not interested in how much somebody is doing. I'm very interested in how they're doing it, because that's what changes the quality of who we are. Because the content of our life will not change our life. It is the context of our life which changes our life. But there's no such thing as this is my life and that's your life. This is a living cosmos. Everybody is free to capture as much as they want. If you capture substantial amount of life, your very presence will become a significant life. Otherwise, you will become a mediocre life. This is the important thing. It's not the knowledge you gather in your head. It's not the muscle that you gather in your body. It's the life. How much of a life are you? This will make you significant in your very presence. If world gives us an opportunity, we'll do something impactful. Otherwise, we're just a significant presence. Beautiful does not mean just a beautiful view of the ocean or something else. Beautiful means human life here is pleasant within every human being. The question is not about what I wear, what I drive, where I live, but how I am within myself. Human experience is constant. Whichever generation you are, you can either be blissed out or misery. What we can do in the world is subject to many realities of the times. But how we can be within ourselves is always a possibility. So what is always a possibility must be manifested. Whether you will run faster than Mr. Bolt or not, whether you will climb Mount Everest or not, this is not the point. Those things are subject to individual tastes and individual likes and dislikes. But will your experience of life on this planet be pleasant or not? At least this one thing we must determine, that every human being's experience of life on this planet is pleasant. That much we must do, and it's doable.